好，同学们，今天我们学习第四课。Today we will learn lesson four。他是我的汉语老师。他是我的汉语老师。She is my Chinese teacher. Today we will review what we learned in last week. Review lesson three. Then we will learn some new pinyin knowledge. And today we will focus on some new words and grammars. First, let's review lesson 3. In lesson 3, we learned how to distinguish 鸡, 七, 西, these three 声母. And we know 鸡, 七, 西 are known as coronal. The surface of the tongue touches the hard palate when pronouncing 鸡 and 七. The difference between 鸡 and 七 is that when we pronounce 七, it brings out more airflow. When 七 is pronounced, the surface of the tongue approaches the hard palate without reaching it, leaving a gap in between. Okay, now let's do a practice. I will read the pinyin. Please write the 声母 you hear. Okay, now let's do it. The first one, 休息. 休息, 休息. Yes, very good. 休息. Now it means to have a rest. 休息. Okay, next. 积极, 积极, 积极. Oh, okay. These are two different answers. I read it again. 积极. Yes, it should be this one. 积极. Okay, next. 机器. 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 Very good. 机器. Okay, next. 小区, 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 小区. Good, it's 小, 西, and 区, 七, 小区. Okay, next one. Oh, sorry. 星期, 星期, 星期. Very good. 星期, it means week. Next one. 香蕉, 香蕉. Good, 香蕉. Now it means banana. 香蕉. Next one. 兴趣. 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 Very good. 兴, 西, 趣, 七, 兴趣. Okay, the last one. 继续, 继续, 继续. Perfect, well done. 继续, it means to continue. 好, do you remember these three sentences we learned in last class? Let's read them together. 好久不见, 好久不见. Long time no see. 好久不见. 请问一下, 请问一下. May I ask? 请问一下. 休息休息, 休息休息. To have a rest. Okay, last week we also learned how to distinguish 滋, 呲, 斯. These three 声母 are all dentals. One pronounce z and ci. The front part of the tongue tip touches the inner surface of the upper teeth. While when we pronounce ci, it brings out more airflow. When pronounce ci, your tongue tip will not touch the inner surface of the upper teeth all along, leaving a gap for the airflow to get through. Si. Okay, we will also do a practice. Let's have a try. The first one, 洗澡, 洗澡, 洗澡. Very good. It should be 洗澡. And do you find I read it like 洗澡. These two pinyin, they both are third tongue, but I didn't read 洗澡. Do you still remember this knowledge? Yes, we have learned that if there are two third tongues, the first third tongue should be changed into the second tongue. So we should read 洗澡, not 洗澡. 洗澡, it means to take a bath. 洗澡. Next one. 打扫, 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 打扫. Yes, very good. It should be 撕, 撕. Now, see, 打扫, this pinyin also two third tongues. The first 打 should be changed into the second tongue. 打扫. Okay, next one. 三次, 三次, 三次. Very good. 三次, three times. 三次. Next. 自己, 自己, 自, 自己. Good. It should be 自, 自己. Next. 昨天, 昨天, 昨天. Good. It should be 自, 昨天. Next one. 早上, 早上, 早上. Very good. 早上, it should be 自. Do you remember the meaning of 早上? 早上, it means morning, in the morning, 早上. Next one. 操场, 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 操, 操场. It should be 吃 or 滋, which one? 操场. Very good. 吃, 操场. Okay, the last one. 汉字, 汉字. Very good. 汉字. What's the meaning of 汉字? Do you know? 汉字, it means, what's the meaning? 汉字, it means Chinese characters. 汉字, Chinese character. Okay, these three sentences we learned in last class. Let's read them together. 早上好, 早上好. Good morning. 早上好. 再来一次, 再来一次. Once again. 再来一次. 放松一下, 放松一下. To relax. Good. Now let's do a challenging practice. I will read a sentence. Please choose the syllable you hear. For example, like the first one, I will read 下午我去商店。下午我去商店。So in this sentence, we can choose. Very good. You already know the answer. It should be B. 下午我去商店。Okay, next sentence. 我想买一些水果。我想买一些水果。Very good. The answer should be A, right? Do you find 水果? It means fruit. 水果. And they both third tongue. So in this case, we should change the first third tongue into the second tongue. 水果。Okay, next one. 这个星期很忙。这个星期很忙。这个星期很忙。Very good. The answer should be C, right? 这个星期很忙。Next one.我昨天没出门。我昨天没出门。我昨天没出门。So the answer should be yes, B. Very good. 昨天 it means yesterday. Okay, next one. 我在操场等你。我在操场等你。我在操场等你。Oh, I saw different answers. I will read it again. 我在操场等你。操场。Yes, it should be C, right? 操场 playground.吃操场。OK, the last one. 我不吃苹果。我不吃苹果。我不吃苹果。Very good. The answer should be B, right? 不吃。不吃。OK, we have reviewed some pinyin in last class. Now let me check if you still remember these new words and do you still remember how to read them. The first one, A, it should be which one? A is, yes, good. 什么什么什么 What does it mean? What's the meaning? 什么什么Very good. 什么 it means what. We use it to ask what. Next. Next one. Very good. 名字名字、啊、名字 it means 名字 it means yes, name.、啊、你的名字 your name, 名字 Next. Good. 老师老师那老师 it means teacher, right? 啊，王老师，我是王老师，老师。Next one. Good. 学生，学生 student, 学生，你是学生吗？你是学生吗？学生。Yeah, 是的，很好啊 ，very good. 好 ，these four characters, do you still remember their 拼音？The first one, yes, 是是啊，是 is a verb that means to be. 是 next, good. 我我那 it means I, me, 我 next, yes, 妈妈那妈 we use it at the end of a sentence to ask yes or no. 妈 next one.Yes, 人, 人, it means people or person. Nah, yeah, very good. 人. Okay, we have know the their pinyin. So now let me check if you still remember their meaning. Can you finish these four sentences? Choose the proper word. I give you some time to finish them. Okay, are you ready? Okay, you can send your answer in the chat box. Number 1, 我叫李月，你叫，we should choose A. Very good. 你叫什么名字？你叫什么名字？什么啊？什么名字？We use it to ask one's name. What's your name? 你叫什么名字？Number two，你好，你是美国学生？Yes，吗？啊，we can see there is a question mark at the end of a sentence, so we can know it's a question, and we should choose C 吗 to ask yes or no。你好，你是美国学生吗？Can you answer it? How to answer this question？你是美国学生吗？How to answer it? If the answer is no, how to say? 对，我不是美国学生。Very good. 我不是美国学生。Good. Number three. 对不起，我不是学生，我是。很好，我是 choose D 老师。对不起。我不是学生，我是老师。OK，number four，the last one，we should choose B. Good，我不是 David，我是张老师，我是张老师。Very good。好，next practice，let's try to put the words into a sentence. Have a try the first one. If you can type the sentence in the chat box or just type numbers. Very good. The first one we should write 你叫什么名字? Good, it's a question. 你叫什么名字? 我叫米多, that's your answer. Very good. 你叫什么名字? Next one. 是 your answer。Very good，我不是美国人，我不是美国人。不，we can put 不 before verb or adjective to give a negative form。我不是美国人。OK，next one，we can see there is a 吗，right？So it should be a question. What's your answer? Very good. 您是老师吗？您是老师吗？Can you try to answer it? 您是老师吗？Please answer me. 您是老师吗？Yes, very good. 我不是老师。You can say 我不是老师，我是学生。Very good. 我不是老师，我是学生。Okay, well done. I have checked your pinyin and vocabulary, but our purpose in learning grammar and vocabulary is to communicate. So now let's try to finish this conversation according to the picture. I give you 1 minute to consider about it. Okay, are you ready? Let's have a try. We start from A. 你好，我叫 Jessica. So we should say A is introduce herself. So 你呢？你呢？That's a grammar today. Yes, very good. We can say 你叫什么名字？你叫什么名字？So B 是 the answer. Her name. 你好，我叫 Apple. Here I give you an example. You can use your name. 你好，我叫 Laura. A ask. It's a question. 你是美国人吗？你是美国人吗？B should say how to answer it. B can say 我不是美国人，我不是美国人。OK, now according to B, B said 我不是老师，我是学生。So to this answer, A should ask. A can say, Yes, very good. 你是老师吗？你是老师吗？我不是老师，我是学生。Very good. Okay, this is lesson 3. This is lesson 3. Now we will study today's 拼音. Today's 拼音. Okay, first let's study how to distinguish 知, 吃, 诗, and 日. These four 声母 are a series of catechumenals, which are pronounced with the tongue tip turned up and coordinating with the front of the heart palate. It means when we pronounce 知, 吃, 诗, and 日, our tongue tip should raise up. When we pronounce 知 and 吃, the tongue tip touches the heart palate, then opens a gap to let the air flow. The difference between 知 and 吃 is that when we pronounce 吃, it brings out more airflow. 吃 is pronounced, the tongue tip doesn't touch the heart palate, leaving a gap all along. 吃 日 is pronounced with the vocal cords vibrating. You can put your hands here and you can feel 日, vibrating. Now let's do a practice. I will read a syllable. You can choose which one you hear. Number one, 支持, 支持, 支持. Once again. 支持, 持, it should be, yes, A is right, 支持. Okay, next. 燃烧, 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 very good. C is right. Next. 手掌, 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 手掌. Which one is right? Yes, it should be C. 手掌. See, there are two third tones. The first third tone should be changed into the second tone. 手掌. Okay, next one. 出差, 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 出差. Which one is right? 出, it should be. Yes, B is right. 出差, C is 抽, 抽, B is 出, 出, B is right. Okay, this is 知, 吃, 诗, and 日. Now let's look at N and ng, these two 韵母. When we pronounce N, the tongue tip should press the upper teeth. Upper and lower teeth close to each other. N, N. But when we pronounce N, the back part of tongue, The back part of your tongue forms an arch, and the root of the tongue moves back and presses the soft palate. In this case, the mouth more wide open. You can compare these two pinyin. I will read them. You listen to me carefully. The first one, an, an, yan, yan, yang, yang, wen, wen, wong, wong, ying, 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 ying. Okay, now let's have a try. I will read one syllable. You can choose which one you hear. Number one, Chang Jiang, Chang Jiang, Chang Jiang, Chang Jiang. A B and a C, which one is right? Once again, Chang Jiang, Jiang, which one? It should be B. C, B is Jiang, Jiang. C is Jian, Jian. See, they are different. Next, Cheng Xian, Cheng Xian, Cheng Xian, Cheng Xian. Very good. A is right. Cheng Xian. Next. Jing Shen, Jing Shen, Jing Shen, Jing Shen. Very good. B is right. Okay, next one. Fen Xiang, Fen Xiang, Fen Xiang, Xiang, Fen Xiang. Which one is right? Yes. C is right. Fen Xiang. Okay. Do you remember in last class we learned bu? Bu can be changed, we should change its tongue according to different pinyin. Bu, when we use it before the first tongue, second tongue, third tongue, it should be changed into the fourth tongue, right? 不吃, 不行, 不好. Do you remember it? But when we use it before the fourth tongue, it should be changed into the second tongue. For example, like 不是, 不是. Okay, and today we will learn 一, 一. 一 should also change its tongue according to different pinyin. 一, its character, maybe it must be the easiest one in Chinese. There is only one stroke. 一, it means one. When 一 is used alone or in a number, its tongue doesn't change. First tongue, 一. For example, 第一, 第一, first. 十一, 十一, 11. 星期一, 星期一, Monday. In these three words, 一 will not change its tongue. But when 一 is used followed by a syllable in the fourth tongue, it changes into the second tongue. For example, 一定, 一定, it means sure. 一定, 一块, 一块 one piece，一样一样 same。OK，and when e is used followed by a syllable in the first, second, or third tone, it changes into the fourth tone. For example, 一张 one sheet。一条，一起 it means together. See, 一 now has three different tones. Do you remember them? When we use it alone or in a number, we should use the first tone. 第一, 十一, 星期一, right? But when we use it before a fourth tone, this one, before a fourth tone, we should change e into the second tone. 一定，一块，一样. But when we use it before first, second, and third tone, e should be changed into the fourth tone. 一张，一条，一起. Okay, let's read them together. See this word. 心 and 意, according to the pinyin followed 一, can you tell me which tongue it is? 心 is the first tongue, right? Before the first tongue, 一, we should read which one? We should read the fourth tongue, right? See here, we should read the fourth tongue now. Before the first tone, second tone, or third tone, e should be changed into the fourth tone. And e, this one, e is the fourth tone, so e should be changed into the second tone, right? So we should read 一心一意, 一心一意. It means put one's whole heart into something. Now focus on something. 一心一意. Okay, next. 小心点儿. Dear is the third tongue, right? So in this case, we should read which tongue? Yes, very good. 小心一点儿. 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 It means to be careful. 小心一点儿. Next, 长下. Here, 下 is fourth tongue, right? So 长 e should be changed into the second tongue. Very good. 长一下. 长一下. 长一下 means have a taste. 长一下. Okay, this is 一. And now we will learn some. We also learned some rules of pinyin. Do you remember this? 鸡, 七, 西, when they used together with 鱼, what will we do? When we use 鱼 after 鸡, 七, 西, the two dots above 鱼 should be removed. Now we should say goodbye to these two dots. Like 居, 屈, 虚. Here are all 韵母 are headed by 鱼. When they use together with 鸡, 七, 西, see the two dots are removed. Today we will learn a new rule of pinyin. This is the usage of Y and W in pinyin. Do you remember? Pinyin consists of three parts, 声母, 韵母, and 声调. In the first class, I told you, 声母 is not necessary in a pinyin, so sometimes there is only 韵母 and 声调. For example, 一, 乌, 吁, these three finals, or the finals beginning with 一, 乌, 吁, can be used alone. But 一, 乌, 吁, they can also used together with other 声母, For example, like this word, 房屋, 房屋, it means house. If we don't use W here in writing form, 房屋, there may be two possibilities. Sometimes we will read 房屋, sometimes maybe we can read 房屋, right? Because we don't know here, 屋, we use it alone or together with 哥. That's why we should use Y and W. So Y and W, they are dividing mark to tell to distinguish them from other 声母. So how to use them? Let's look at this table. If it's a simple finals, we can just use Y and W before finals. Put it before finals. Like the 韵母 beginning with E, E, Yin, Yung, we can just put Y before it. If it's U, we just put W before U. Here, U is a little bit special. When we use U or 韵母 headed with U, we should put Y before it. And at the same time, the two dots above U should also be removed. Yu, Yue, Yuan, and Yun. See here, two dots are removed. And these finals, they are compound finals. Ya, Ye, Yao, Yan, Yang, Yong. This beginning with E. In this case, we should use Y or W to replace E and U. We use Y to replace E. We use W to replace U. Here, 我. We can see, actually, it should be 我, 我, but in written form, we use W to replace U. Okay, this is some rules of Y and W. Do you remember these three 韵母? Yu, Wei, and Wen. They are abbreviation form. So we omit all and but they can also be used alone. In this case, we should use Y and W to replace E or U. This table summarizes the usage of Y and W. You can take a picture of it. When we write, when we use E, U, U, or the 韵母 headed by E, U, U alone, don't forget to put Y and W before them. Okay, these are pinyin knowledge we learned today. Now let's go to the new words and grammars. First, let's look at these four words. 我, 我们, 你, 你们. I think you still remember their meaning, right? 我 means I. 我们, we. 你, you. 你们, you, plural. Okay, let's look at this picture. This picture, there are two people in this picture. The female and a male. So how to say, how to say he and she? We use he and she. We use 他. 他 means he. And here, we also use 他. It represents she. Please look at these two characters carefully. Can you find what's the difference between these two characters? They share the same pronunciation, but the characters are different. Do you find it? Let's look at their left part. Their left part are different, right? 她, it means she. Its left part is 女, 女. Now it represents female, female. So although they share the same pronunciation, but their 汉字, their characters are different. 好, 她 is he, 她, she. So together, 他们, 他们, it means they, 他们. Okay, let's look at this picture. Can you use 他, 他, 他们 to make some sentences? Here, I have some sentences for you. First one, for example, 他们是中国人. 他们是中国人. 他是老师吗? 他是老师吗? 他是学生. 他是学生. 他叫什么名字? 他叫什么名字? Good. These words, I think all of you know it. 汉语, 汉语, Chinese language. We can say 汉语老师, 汉语老师. And this word, this phrase, 学习汉语. Do you know what's the meaning? 学习汉语. 学习, 学习, it means, yes, to study, to learn. 学习, 学习汉语, to study Chinese. Let's look at some sentences. 他是汉语老师. 他是汉语老师. He is a Chinese teacher. 他是汉语老师吗? 他是汉语老师吗? 我们学习汉语. 我们学习汉语. Good. Next, this is 的. 的, we use it after an attribute. Before introduce the function of 的, I will introduce you a new word. This one, 书, 书. It means the book, right? 书, 书, it means book. Let's look at this phrase. 我的书, 我的书, 我, 书, this 书 belongs to me, 我的书, so it means my book, my book. Next one, 你们的老师, 你们的老师. In this sentence, 你们的老师, your teacher, your teacher. So can you tell me what's the function of the in this phrase, in these two phrases, what's the function of the? We use the between a noun pronoun or a noun to indicate position, to indicate the position. Let's look at these three phrases. 他的书, 他的书, her book, 我们的学校, 我们的学校, our school. 他的电脑, 他的电脑, his computer. Okay, and these three phrases. 我的爸爸, 他的学生, 我们的老师. Okay, the, we use it between a noun, pronoun, and a noun. Okay, let's look at the left part and the right part. According to these two parts, can you find what's the difference between left part and the right part? They are nouns. 书, 学校, 电脑, 爸爸, 学生, 老师. These words are all represent person, people, right? So when the noun following 的 is a term of kinship or indicate a person, can be omitted. 我的爸爸, you can also say 我爸爸. 他的学生, we can also say 他学生. 我们的老师, 我们老师. Let's look at more sentences. 这是我的书, 这是我们的学校. 她是我的妈妈, 妈妈. It's a person, right? So we can omit this 的. 她是我妈妈. Last one. 她是我的汉语老师. 她是我的汉语老师. See here, before 老师 there is a modifier, 汉语。In this case, if there is a modifier before a noun, the usually not omitted. We should use the that's better. Okay, next word, 谁，谁。I will show you two conversations. According to these two conversations, you can tell me what's the meaning of 谁。The first one，他是谁？他是我爸爸。他们是谁？他们是我老师。Okay, according to these two conversations, can you tell me what's the meaning of 谁？Yes, 谁 it means who, whom. We should use 谁 to ask a person. Let's look at some conversations. 他们是谁？他是谁？他是我的汉语老师。他们是谁？他们是我的学生。Okay, let's have a try. Can you complete the conversation according to this picture? I give you 1 minute to finish it. Have a try. 他是我的汉语老师。他是王老师的学生。他们是老师吗？他们是学生。Okay, let's read it together. The first one, 他是谁？Right? 他是谁？他是我的汉语老师。他是谁？他是王老师的学生。他是老师吗？他们不是老师，他们是学生。Well done. Okay, this one. Have a try. 这是什么？这是什么？According to the picture, can you answer it? 这是什么？这是书。Very good. 这是我的书。Good sentence. 这是我的书。这是谁的书？这是谁的书？这是我的书。Here I use 谁的。It means whose。他是谁的老师？他们是谁的学生？Here 谁的 it means whose. Okay, very good. Now let's listen to the radio. You can read it after it. Okay, let's read the text together.
他是谁？
他是我的汉语老师。他叫李月。
Okay, once again.
他是谁？
他是我的汉语老师，他叫李月。
Very good，很好。Let's look at next word。中国，中国啊，we all know 中国，it means China。Here，国，it means country，国。Now I introduce you some countries name. 美国、韩国、法国。In these three names, I use 国 in the word. Okay, next. These three, they are also countries name. 俄罗斯、埃及、津巴布韦。Do you find what's the difference between them? These three countries' name, I don't use 国 after it, because when we translate the name of the country in Chinese, we on very formal occasions we will use the full name. But in general, as long as the short name is enough, if the abbreviation has only one Chinese character, then we will add 国 after it. If it is two or more Chinese characters, There is no need to add 国 after the name. You can try to translate the name of your country into Chinese. If there is only one character, you should use 国 after it. If it's more than one character, you don't need to use 国 after your country's name. For example, let's look at some sentences. 他是法国人。他妈妈是俄罗斯人。See, here, 法国, we use 国。俄罗斯, three characters, we don't use 国。Yes, that's your country's name, 巴基斯坦。See, four characters, we don't use 国 after it. This word, 哪, 哪。哪, it means which, 哪国人。It literally means which country person. 你是哪国人?你是哪国人? It literally means you are which country person. It means which country are you from? We can use it to ask the other's nationality. 你是哪国人?你是哪国人?我是中国人。Okay, if I ask you, 你是哪国人? Can you answer me? Yes, very good. 我是佛得角人。佛得角。Okay, 你是哪国人?我是中国人。Let's look at this. See?我是中国人，你呢？你呢？啊，here is a new word， 呢？你呢？你呢 ？We used 呢 used at the end of a question to ask the other about the situation mentioned previously. So in this sentence， 我是中国人，你呢 ？We can translate into How about you and you？ 我是中国人。你呢？我是美国人。We can also use it in this conversation. 我叫张好。你呢？我叫 David. To ask one's name. 你呢？那 How about you? And you? 他呢？他呢？他呢 ？It means how about her? 那 it means to ask the same situation mentioned previously. To ask her name.他是我老师，他叫李月。Okay, now let's read this text.
你是哪国人？
我是美国人。你呢？
我是中国人。
Okay, once again.
你是哪国人？
我是美国人，你呢？
我是中国人。
Very good. Next word, let's look at these two pictures. They study together. So can you tell me what's the relationship between them? They study together, so they are 同学，同学 classmate, my classmate. How to say in Chinese?My classmate, we can say, very good, 我的同学，我的同学，我同学 they both represent person, right? So this 的, we can omit it, 我同学，我同学，他是我同学， she is my classmate. Let's look at this picture. 他们是朋友。Friend, right? Friend, 朋友，朋友。So, 他们是什么？他们是，他们是朋友，他们是朋友，他们是好朋友，好朋友。Can you tell me what's the meaning? 好朋友。What does it mean? Ah, good. 好朋友 it means good friend, 好朋友。Okay, let's read this conversation together.
他是谁？
他是我同学。
他呢？他是你同学吗？
他不是我同学，他是我朋友。
Once again.
他是谁？
他是我同学。
他呢？他是你同学吗？
他不是我同学，他是我朋友。
Very good. Okay, these are new words we learned today. Okay, do you still remember them? Please read after me. 他，他，谁的汉语，哪国呢？同学，朋友。Okay, can you read them without 拼音? Let's have a try. 他，他，谁，谁的，的。汉语，汉语，哪，哪，国，国，呢，呢，同学，同学，朋友，朋友。 Very good. Now let's do a practice.Let me check if you remember this, their meanings. Okay, let's do them together. Are you ready? 的 first one, 你妈妈。Which one should I choose? Which I choose? Very good. 你妈妈叫什么？你妈妈叫什么？This sentence is used to ask one's name. 你妈妈叫什么? Next, 您是... Good, we should choose A. 您是哪国人? Which country? 您是哪国人? Next one. 他不是我同学,他是我... Yes, very good. We should choose C. 他是我的中国朋友。 OK, last one. 我是美国人，你 good, 你呢，你呢、so here, 你呢 it means, what's the meaning? 你呢 it means, how about you and you? 我是美国人，你呢？ OK, next one. 他是 yes, good.他是谁？他是谁啊、？Next, 我 good, 我不是中国人，我是美国人。Next one, 他是你的汉语老师。Good, 吗？他是你的汉语老师吗 ？Last one, 他不是我同学，他。Yes, it's easy. 他是我的好朋友，我的好朋友啊、my best friend, my good friend. Okay, here, please judge if the sentence describe the picture correctly. The first one, 他们是我朋友 true or false, according to the picture. 他们是我朋友。对还是错 ？True or false? Yes. 对啊 ，correct. Next. 我是中国人，你呢 ？Is it right? 我是中国人，你呢 ？Yes, I false 啊，不对，不对 ，very good. Next one. 我们是同学，我们是同学。对吗 ？Yes, 对的啊 ，It's true. 我们是同学。Next, 你是哪国人？对吗？你是哪国人？According to the picture, is it right? Yes, it's false. 错的啊，不对。你是哪国人？这个不对。OK. Now let's put words into a sentence. Have a try. The first one. You can type the sentence. You can also just type letters. Very good. 他是我的朋友啊。Here is 朋友，not 老师啊。他是我的朋友，他是我的朋友。OK，next one。Here is only this picture. Okay, wait a moment. Maybe some mistake in this. Sorry, wait a moment. OK，Can you see the PowerPoint? Okay, let's go on. I'm sorry. That's some problem with the system. Let's go on. Next one. Please have a try. Yes, very good. It should be 他是谁? 他是谁? Okay, this one. Very good. 这是谁的书? 这是谁的书? Okay, next. Thank you, 谢谢你们啊, let's go on. We just have some practice, let's go on. It should be, yes, very good. 王老师是哪国人? Okay, next one. Yes, good. 我们是好朋友。 我们是好朋友. Next one. Very good. 他们是你同学吗? 他们是你同学吗? Okay. Here is the practice of sentences. Now I will give you a homework. Can you try to finish it? You can introduce yourself or try to use the words we learned, because we have learned some words about country, about how to say hello. So now we can introduce ourselves. You can write a short passage or a conversation. You can have a try. And next week, you can send your passage in the chat box. I will read your sentences. It's our homework. So next, you can take a picture of this PowerPoint. Next week, you can send your answer here. Next week, we will review this lesson and we will study some new knowledge of Pinyin. And at last, we will focus on some the new grammars. So from next class, we can count the numbers from 1 to 100. We can also inquire the number or briefly describe changes in things and inquiry age in next time. Before say goodbye, I have some good news to you. I bring you this good news. Chinese Plus app is online. Through this app, you can learn a lot of Chinese and cultural courses. If you are a teacher, you can complete vocational training online, improve teaching skills, and communicate with excellent teachers worldwide. So welcome to download this Chinese Plus app. That's all, that's today's class. If you have some questions, you can ask me here. Thank you so much. Okay, today we did a lot of practice. If you have any questions, you can ask me here. And there are some. 谢谢你们. 好, 再见, 谢谢你们. Do you have any questions?